Hey guys, welcome back to Commander vs. Series, Season 5, Episode 1. Justin Parnell, Jeremy Noell, Season 4 champion, Stephen Green.
And Season 3 champion. Let's not forget, back-to-back, repeat.
And season,
Dynasty.
You want to talk about repeating? How about Season 1, Season 2, Season 5, Season 4, runner-up, John Suarez.
I see what you did there, and
impressive.
I liked it.
It's impressive.
Season 5 runner-up as well.
It's impressive.
Yeah, I just wanted, I don't want to get ahead of ourselves. You know, we just started the season. Obviously, we're back. Season 5. Sometimes, Stephen, you're usually the one that says something's not going to happen, and then it happens.
Yeah, Triscadella.
So, do you think that John's going to get second place this season also?
It'll never happen.
Never.
Never happen.
Yeah. He's going to be first.
Well, Stephen, you were the one that got first at the end of last season when we crowned you champion for the second time in the recap video.
Yes.
And as your reward,
I'm now green.
I believe that I helped that.
I'm now green
between seasons.
So for all of you on Team Green that have been waiting for this moment,
all it took was back to a dynasty. Formulation of a dynasty, basically.
Yeah. He couldn't be denied any longer, and we were really getting tired of hearing him run his mouth. That's really what it came down to.
It's only going to get worse now.
Perfectly honest. Well, it's not going to. I don't think it's going to get worse because you're going to start off.
It's going to get worse for you.
In my opinion, you're going to start off in last place.
Did make a strong comeback.
We're all tied for last.
We are all tied for last. It's a new day, a new season. And as such, we like to go back over the point structure for our season. So, just to give you guys a little bit of a recap, obviously, we don't have a leaderboard update today. But our points go as follows. If you get first place, you get 4 points. Second place, 3. Third place, 2. Last place, 1. So everyone's most times always going to at least, just by being here, you're going to get 1 point.
Yeah.
If you cast your general 4 or more times during the video, 1 point. If you get first blood, which means you deal combat damage to another player first, plus 1 point.
Oh, we all know about first blood.
Well, you more than most.
You more recently, yeah.
You. And if during the video you save another player at any time, you get 1 point. Now, you can't get it multiple times. It's just
it's one time
if you
now.
Do it, one point.
1 point per episode.
Yeah. 1 point per episode. Now
guys, they see how I won,
there's
and they go back
ways,
and adjust the rules to stop it.
There's also ways to lose points.
You know, maze of it, then they're all...
If you attack, and you don't even have to deal damage, but if you direct your attack, the first attack of the game at the person in sole possession of last place, so not someone tied for last, but if sole possession of last, minus 1 point. If you do not cast your general the entire game, minus 1 point. If you kill all of the other players, 3 other players, if everyone's still in the game, you kill 3 other people all at the same time, like with the same spell or in the same combat, minus 1 point. And if you take 40 seconds or more on a search, you get minus 1. And each 30 seconds you take after that initial 40, so a minute 10... A minute.
If you take a minute 10 to search, you deserve it.
Every extra 30 seconds, you get another minus one. So, with everyone caught up, let's get to our theme. Now, this is something you guys have been asking for a really, really long time.
As we say, every single episode.
Now, you know why we say that every single episode, Jeremy?
Because we ask for it.
And we give you guys what you want. If I didn't say it every episode, that would mean that we're not doing what they asked for, and we are doing what they asked for.
Doing what we want.
Yeah.
It's true.
Sometimes, you know, as a parent would like to say, we know what's best for you. You might not like it sometimes. You might not think you like it when you look at the video, but you're going to like it when you watch.
Yeah.
But other times, we do what you guys want to do. This is one of those times. We wanted to lead off Season 5 strong, so we're playing decks we all know very well. In fact, we're playing the decks that we know better than every other deck. Because our theme to lead off the season is that we are all playing our personal commander decks. Now, I will admit, I know that most of us don't play a ton of Commander outside of Commander Versus because
we play all the time.
We play every week virtually with a new deck. So we don't have a lot of time. We all like to play Magic outside of Commander.
Yeah. Yes. Not only do we play, we also build the decks.
Yeah,
every
we do.
Single week, which takes some time.
It does. If you obviously, if you guys have ever tried to build a Commander deck, and you all have, you know that we put a lot of effort into making sure that those decks are awesome. So that's why we're still here in Season 5 doing this. So it does take a little bit. And these are decks that, like I said, we don't always get to play a ton, but these are kind of our close personal decks that are our favorite. I only have 3 Commander decks that I play just because I don't get that much time to play. But I know mine that I'm playing today, which is Liliana Heretical Healer, is my absolute favorite deck. You guys obviously know me as someone who plays black all the time. It's true.
And big surprise.
Personal.
Yeah. He's playing Liliana.
Mono black. Mono black.
How many grave pact effects do you have in there?
We only have one grave pact.
But all of the effects.
Yeah. How many can you have?
All of them.
Yes is the answer to that question. Yes is the answer to that question. So I have Liliana Heretical Healer. This is my absolute favorite deck. It does everything I want to do. I put creatures into play and then sacrifice them. In turn, if that makes you guys sacrifice creatures too,
no big deal. Yeah.
So Liliana, in my opinion, is the most fun general to do with that because she's going to reap some pretty awesome rewards if you're sacking your own creatures. Namely, turning into a sweet planeswalker, putting a zombie into play, and probably having some other crazy effect like making me draw a card or making you guys sacrifice a creature. And then, of course, I got a lot of black, so I'm on a black devotion. I got some devotion cards in here. Aberrant Overlord is a really sweet one. Puts a lot of tokens into play. Also lets me sacrifice creatures. Spawning Pit's one of my favorite ones. Lets me do it at will. Three things that sacrifice things are really great because you don't have to put a lot of work into it. It's just there. When someone tries to exile all of your black creatures or something, like if that were to ever happen.
Can't think of anything that would do that.
You just got a way to do it immediately. Ghoulcaller Gissa, before Liliana came out, was actually the general for this deck, but she draws a lot of heat.
Yeah,
so
I would imagine.
You can't just let her hang around.
I imagine a flip to Liliana also draws some heat.
It does, but she's harder to kill than Ghoulcaller Gissa.
Yeah.
You might be surprised. Yeah. So, now, I'm not the only one playing black. Jeremy and Steven have identified black as the best color in Commander.
We paired it with the other two best colors.
I paired it with the other two, for sure. So for mine, as you said, this is one of my two Commander decks that I have currently. Mm-hmm. Trying to build a third one. It's been taking a while. But I went with the one that I had a little bit more fun with on a regular basis. I do have my Maelstrom Wanderer deck, which is the one that goes a little bit more over the top. It's a little bit more competitive.
We all know about that.
I just like to have fun with this. So it's Tasigur the Golden Fang, but the whole point of the deck is Villainous Wealth. As soon as this card was spoiled, I was like, I want to cast that card as many times as I possibly can. And I did. So I just built the deck to do that. So we've got ways to search it up, ways to search up other cards that I might need in order to go off with the Villainous Wealth, a bunch of big mana. And then a bunch of big cards that also can interact with other people's graveyards just in case, as well as my own graveyard with Tasigur. So that's basically what I'm going to be aiming to do is casting all of your spells as many times as I can.
Well, my spells are really sweet, so
yeah.
I'm going to be pretty
jealous. You may be disappointed.
Yeah.
Why would he be disappointed?
Well, I'm like the rest of you, very, very boring Magic players with all your black spells. I am playing one of my two Commander decks. The other one, Hannah's a little over the top. It's a little oppressive. It's not a lot of fun to watch. I had a lot of fun playing it, but this one is by far my favorite deck. Kangee, Airy Keeper, a.k.a. Birds of War. You've seen it before when we did a budget video way back.
It's true.
However, I got to take out some of the budget restrictions and play better cards now again. So we have all of our bird soldiers. Yes, they have feathers. With muscles,
with muscles of men, of course.
Keeper of Ninegales, you're familiar.
I will admit, I do not have a great conversion rate against the Birds of War.
No. Your competitive commander deck.
On video or not on video.
Yeah.
Yeah. I've got the Mimeomancer Kangee combo 10 years apart from each other.
Oh, yeah. Feather counters.
Yeah, feather
interesting.
Counters.
Who'd have thought?
And then we got some Airborne Aid. We're going to draw a bunch of cards, cast a bunch of birds, beef up their
original Distant Melody.
The original Distant Melody. Yeah. Not an option.
No.
Just had to
you play. Will
What's
play
that
birds.
One in the top right? What's it say?
Which one?
The Lieutenant.
Lieutenant Kirtar?
Yeah.
It's a flying 2/2, and you may sacrifice it to remove target attacking creature from the game. That's probably good against what you're doing over there.
Yeah.
You look like you have specific creatures you want to attack with.
Yeah.
I did outline one combination that I have in my deck, which is Skitherix, Lord of Extinction.
Interesting.
Which could potentially kill one person at a time, you know.
Unless that person has Lieutenant Kirtar.
Or, you know, Path Swords, 100 different things.
Yeah. Or Grave Pack. Or
something. Yeah, you know, I have a Lightning Greaves. I'm not worried about it. So I'm playing the Mimeoplasm today. It's really the only commander deck that I own. And it's because he has a dinosaur for an arm. That's what really drew me in, you know, originally. You know, it's not every day.
I believe every word of that. Yes,
making that Vorthos themed.
Look at it, man. Deck. Look how strong he is. Like,
if you guys have been watching Commander Versus for a long time, you know Steven really liked he. If you ever hear him talk about Cro-Mat?
Yeah, Cro-Mat. And so I'm basically I'm playing some Buried Alive, some Reanimate, and then a spell you guys may not be familiar with, Compulsion.
Very familiar.
Fantastic card.
It's simply this is all it does. One colorless, one blue. Discard a card from your hand. Draw a card.
Sounds so simple.
Yeah, and then for one colorless, one blue, you can sacrifice Compulsion to draw a card.
Yep.
So seems like really, you know, low power.
You'd think
won't
so.
Do anything.
Yeah. So as someone who has played that card in Standard, has played that card in Commander, because I have it in my one Commander deck that has blue in it. Most certainly have Compulsion, and have it in my cube. It looks so innocuous.
It is quite good.
If you care about messing with your graveyard at all and you have blue mana, God, you need to play Compulsion for sure.
Just lets you, you're getting so many, I'm playing basically your Reanimator deck, you're getting so many situations where you're just like, all right, well, how do I get my Sepulture Primordial into the graveyard? And then you've got so many ways. This is a static one. It just sets in play.
It's a good one.
And just lets you do it.
It's not great to remove because they're going to just draw a card and try to kill it, like kill your spell. And a lot of spells, a lot of things in like Commander, you're like if I wanted to like Aura Blast that.
It's not going to work.
No. I'm just not going to draw a card.
Wait till I tap out.
Yeah. Which won't happen.
Yeah. I played this, you know, for the Road to Season 5 Champion. To start off on a
start off
good
strong.
Note.
Hey, yeah. I mean, this is your you know, get your dinosaur
I have
arm
played
out.
An iteration of this deck once before.
Yeah,
the very first video I've ever done.
For the very first four player commander video way back in 1984.
Yes, I played with David Jesse
9 years before
and Christopher Van Meter.
Yeah,
and didn't go well.
Yeah.
Way back they picked on me the whole game and I lost.
Well, it seems like a good time to have history repeat itself, doesn't it? Look, you're in the driver's seat. You're the champion. You're the two-time champion.
To be fair, I got double Cryptic Commanded in one turn. That could possibly happen again.
That very well could happen.
Could.
Steven, I'm just going to let you know. I'm coming for the crown.
All right, well.
Not the crown that Jeremy had.
That was mine.
Clearly, if you're going to get bit, okay? Get chomped.
Bit by a T-Rex?
Yeah. Or a black dragon. Or some freaky green
dragon.
I don't think
something.
That's biting anything.
Dragon skeleton, I'm sorry.
It's just, you're going to get oozed on.
I do not want that. I don't want to get oozed on, I'll be honest. Well, if you guys are ready, for Season 5, we'll see you in the game. Steven, now since we don't have anybody in last,
You're gonna punish reward me.
Some faces.
Yeah.
One of these faces will be going first.
So it's a reward if I pick me. It's a punishment if I pick John.
It's a... Because
that makes me go last.
That's right.
Just go on and punish yourself now.
Treat yourself. Jeremy.
Hey,
you get to go second.
Kind of reward.
That's not what I wanted.
That's right. Get punished. Remember how in the deck tech you were saying you were coming after me?
All right.
Yeah,
starting it off
has not changed. What does it have to do with anything?
That's why you're going last.
I'm gonna go with.
I'm still coming after you.
Last. Luna Delta. I'm gonna fetch and pass.
You're also last, Steven. You know why?
I'm gonna get a shock and put it into play tapped.
39. Steven, you're also last. You know why
I'm gonna do the same thing. Yep. I'm getting a breeding bull.
If you're not first.
You're last. Whatever you say, Ricky.
Do we have a lot of Shockland to play?
Nope, not me. Play an Expedition map.
No Shockland?
No Shockland.
Can I guess?
Shocking.
Not even allowed. Mm. The only Shockland I can play is Tarnished Citadel, and I'm not doing that. I'm done after that.
All right.
All right.
All right. One tap.
So that puts me and him to 39.
Mm-hmm. Yep, both at 39. Picked up right where we left off last season with Jeremy going first. Forrest.
Different seat. Winner seat.
The winner. So that means I'm going to win.
That makes you in the loser seat, Steven.
That's what I'm hearing.
All right, can we cut for a second?
Yeah.
Because there's a Lord of Extinction in the command zone. We need to cut because I cannot keep playing with this f***ing Lord of Extinction in the command zone. Nothing to see here. Nothing to see here.
Evolving Wilds.
Yeah.
Get them basics.
Yeah.
Sometimes you need to get them.
Them basic shock dual lands.
Hey, man. You never know.
I'll play some basics.
I'll ramp up a little bit, too, with the Talisman.
Oh, whoa.
Look at you, cheater.
Starting off big.
Hey, what are you getting with that Expedition map?
We'll find out next turn, because I'm going to play Bitter Blossom this turn.
Ooh.
Does that make birds?
Pass turn. It does not. It
makes fairies.
And rogues. Mm.
Which is important.
Don't know if those are better than bird soldiers, but...
Three mana, what you got?
Not going to be, probably.
What do you think I got?
Cultivate.
Kadama's Reach.
Kadama's Reach.
That's a point,
Steven,
right?
You lose 2 points. John gets one.
Is that how we're playing now?
I agree. Well, he guessed.
Whenever you guess.
Putting a swamp, and then I'm going to get a force, put it in my hand, and I'll be done.
All right. I'm going to do that while you do this.
Actually,
I'm going to get a force down in my deck. Okay. Or an island, whichever one I see first. So... Said I saw all swamps first. Oh, there it is.
Steven, what is...
I don't know, man.
...going on today?
I don't know.
It has been a day for Steven.
It has been a day. All right. Draw for the turn. That's a good card. We're going to go ahead and play this. Play a Phyrexian Arena.
All right.
You done?
Yeah, I'm done. New Phyrexian Arena.
Yeah.
New art.
It's got the color.
It should just be called New Phyrexian Arena.
Yeah, that should be the name.
Then I could play 2.
A spark of resistance against the tide of corruption. New flavor text. Mm-hmm. I think the first one's about Urza killing or Gerard killing.
It's not bad.
What does that do?
It's going to get lifelink.
3-2 with lifelink if I pay a white.
All right. 39 for me.
So it begins.
Draw.
I'm going to get... Just because I'm back-to-back champion, I'm going to get attacked a lot.
Maybe. You think that's what's going to happen?
Well, if I make sure that I'm in last place for the first video or two...
I think that it's going
to
happen.
It'll be easier to sneak up from behind.
I'm going to pass the turn.
I played this deck a lot, and I feel like my first few turns always end up being an Arctic Haven. More like a Stormcrow. I love it.
Just like the normal.
The old Stormcrow.
We don't have Stormcrow.
Is it
this one?
Yeah.
You didn't play Stormcrow?
I did not play Stormcrow.
That was off budget anyway.
We amped it up a little bit this time.
Sometimes five you gotta mana? Treat yourself.
5 mana? What are we doing?
5 mana.
What
does that do again? It is indestructible 4/7. As long as your devotion to black and blue is less than 7, it is not a creature. Creatures I control have tapped. Target player puts the top X cards of his or her library in his or her graveyard. Where X is that creature's top.
Why do we let people?
So you're done?
Target player. You really don't like getting milled, do you?
I think actually, you're right. No, I hate getting milled. Don't do it.
I didn't draw an extra card. I did now.
And now you've lost a life as punishment. You're at 38. Don't try that again.
Don't try this at home, kids.
I'm going to cast Sidisi, a Brood Tyrant.
Okay, what does that do?
When Sidisi, Brood Tyrant enters the battlefield or attacks, put the top 3 cards of your library into your graveyard.
Okay. If you hit a creature.
If I hit a creature, I get a 2/2 Zambi. And I hit an It that betrays. May I borrow a zombie from you?
You can borrow a zombie.
Because I know you have a plethora of them.
I got a zombie or two. I've been known to have zombies.
Some zombies.
And I will be done.
Many zombies?
Yes. Ooh, at least one.
Might even fight a zombie or two. It's a good one. All right.
Well, Justin, you got a flyer. That's probably not going to happen. You got some creatures. You're kind of scared. You know what? Why come at you, Jeremy?
Is it?
No, it doesn't.
Three?
It does not have.
It does not have life.
I am not going to give it life.
But it is three, right?
It is three. It's 36.
As long as I have a plane.
Jeremy's at 36.
36.
I'm going to go ahead and sacrifice it.
That's fine.
Map bite while you're doing your thing.
Yep.
Oh.
I'm going to cast an augury owl and scry three.
He doesn't have the muscles of men.
He does.
You know? No, he does. He looks just like a normal owl.
Listen.
He would have what I call the opposite of the muscles of man. He's the muscles of a bird. Arctic Avon, I'll go with muscly like a man, kind of.
And now we're going to play an Avon Mimeomancer.
Oh, man.
Oh, no.
The Birds
and
of War.
At the beginning of your upkeep, what do you do?
I get to put a feather counter on target creature. And if I do, that creature is a 3-1 and has flying as long as it has a feather counter on it.
You can choose my zombie for me.
No, it's okay.
You can choose my fairy rogue.
No, I don't want to do any of that.
You can choose... Oh.
No.
You can choose the permanent. He can
that
choose this.
That will be it for me.
All right. I'm getting this creature, right? Phyrexian tower
right now.
I'm going to go to 38.
I know, but it's not a creature right now.
38. Draw. Indeed.
If the skies are our only refuge.
What land did you get with Expedition?
I got Phyrexian Tower.
Thank you. I'm sure you showed me. I just didn't look.
Yeah.
Well, it's a swamp, you know, if you play it.
Is there an Urborg in play?
There is.
Oh, baby.
It's a swamp if you were to play it.
I love Urborg.
Yeah. It will be a swamp.
Yes. I'm going to play Singir Autocrat.
Is that going to be followed up by a certain... 6-6 tramp.
Is it going to wear the victims?
Absolutely not.
The something of its victims, like treasures around its neck? I can't remember.
Don't try and ruin it.
It says a thankless job and a death sentence besides.
Would you like to sacrifice three black creatures?
He put three goats in play. It actually put serfs into play, just to be clear.
Sir? Yeah.
Sir.
I'm done.
Serfs.
Yes, serfs.
A large horde of creatures over there.
Yeah. Nice. They'll find their way into a graveyard sooner or later, I'm sure.
I'm going to attack you, so... Yeah, sure.
Probably block.
I'll get a zombie for my actions.
Okay.
Feel like casting Tasigur?
I like zombies.
I feel like casting Tasigur, but I also feel like I need to get...
You can Wrath of God.
Some stuff... Other stuff going on here. So, we're going to cast Blood Gift Demon.
I like the Blood Gift Demon.
Have a 5-4 version of your Phyrexian Arena.
That's correct. But that's
that
target
dies
player.
Much more easily.
You get to target.
Yeah, to target.
You can target me, and you will force me.
Are you finished?
To lose a life.
All right, take my turn. I'm going to draw my card for the turn. Slash, bring my upkeep. I'm going to take Phyrexian Arena.
Yes, in that order, draw my card exactly. For the turn. 37 for Steven.
Not liking this pen.
It doesn't like you?
That's right.
It's the seat.
This is being the special.
There it is.
There it is.
That's a trap.
It's a trap. So, I still can play one
land.
What
else are you
going to
do? You can do whatever you like.
You can do whatever you
like. I will block Sidis if you attack me, though, just letting you know.
I want to play Buried Alive.
Okay.
Any responses here, guys?
Nothing here.
No. Not a
go Gary Grave Troll.
No.
Ooh, shooey. A Sepulchre Primordial.
Let's see where this is going.
And we'll get a Sheldred the Whispering.
I don't like any of this. That seems real.
I get a Sidisi trigger. I get another Zambi.
Here is your favorite zombie token, Steven.
It's cute. And then I will go two attackers.
I'll block.
I will see. I won't block your 2-2 if you want to hit me with your zombie, but I will kill your Sidisi. I'll also block. Birds of War are willing to go to battle.
Of course you'll block. You'll also block. Will you? We'll take Justin. I'm going to trigger Sidisi. Hey, you get a zombie.
It's a lot of zombie action going on. I don't really like it that much.
Great.
It's
much,
you know? Much going on here.
You blocked with a surf?
Yep. Surf's up.
I will now play a Temple of Mystery.
Bad. That's real bad. I hate you.
I will keep...
Got two more of those. The trigger ready
to go. Keep that card on top, and you're up. And just so the people at home can see the card I left on top.
It's a mystery. Why are you doing
this? Oh, I showed
it's Temple of Mystery.
I'll be done.
Didn't you play Bayou?
Flavor fail.
Did I play Temple of Mystery?
No, I played Temple of Mystery.
Wait.
I mean, he's on six lands.
That's because Hikodama's
Reach. That's because Hikodama's
Reach. Cheater.
Yeah.
Let's get it out of here.
I saw this. Oops.
At least you kept it on top.
Yeah. Sure. All right, I need a counter for my Aven. I need a feather counter. Anybody have a feather?
What about this black dice?
That'll have to do. Agrial. Do I
want
to make
you want?
I can make this one a 4/2.
That is correct.
Mm-hmm. Or 4/3. No, I'll just make the Agrial.
3/1?
3/1.
That's now a 3/1 bird.
All right, sure.
Woo!
Let's play the Haven.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, no.
Sacrifice a bird, draw a card.
Sacrificing things is really good.
It is. It's one of my favorites. I know it's one of your favorites,
one of Justin's favorites.
It's great.
I feel like Justin is like T-minus 3 seconds from Grave Pactimus.
I feel like he could Grave Pactimus as well.
I wish. I got some fodder
you
from
got
the Grave
Pactimus. I kind of want some fodder, too, though.
Is there a screech? Right, I heard a screech.
I put two.
What about another screech?
So one white. If you give your upkeep, you get to constantly do that, right?
This?
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh,
yeah. And then I'm going to flash this back. And get two more birds.
You don't say. I've never seen that happen. Of that exact word. Play
That's crazy.
Happened. It's like very popular that
That's
that would
crazy.
Happen. Crazy. Are you going to get it in now?
Oh, yeah. We're getting it in.
I'll block.
Not you, though.
He's probably getting it in
Stevie,
on me.
Stevie, we're going to get it in on you. I'm going to get my guy lifelink.
So you hit me for 6.
I like it. John's at 43. And Steven, you are at 31.
That is correct.
And I'm done.
31, you said?
So that is correct.
I'm going to go to 37. And I will get a little fairy. Okay. We'll play our swamp. Now, what do we want to do?
What do you want to do?
I'm going
to
sacrifice another surf.
Mm.
Get 2 black.
So then you have 6?
Yeah, I have 6. I'm just going to play Phyrexian Gargantua.
Just going to play.
It's okay.
What does that do?
It's not Massacre Worm.
One eye, yeah. when it enters the battlefield, I draw 2 and lose 2.
All right.
I want you to know I'm disappointed in you.
Why is that?
For that art.
I actually like this art.
It's
really,
sweet, but it's not the
original one. It's true. See, okay, so I have a. I'm gonna pass around my attacking.
He also already purchased that.
I do have a thing. I do have a thing. Well, yeah, but I have a thing. I do have a thing about art.
I'm gonna target myself.
I've been playing Magic for a really long time, as most of us have, but I'm not like tied to original printings. If I really just like the art better,
35. I can agree with that. There's some art that I like in the new era of Magic.
I really like
some
art.
That is just so iconic. I can't let go.
Phyrexian Gargantua. It is to me because like I cast that card a lot when I was growing up.
Yeah, you did
a lot.
Yeah.
I also until about 3 years ago thought it was Phyrexian Gargantuan.
No T in there.
No, there's not. Well, there's no N at the end.
Or no N. Yeah. Excuse me. Are you playing this Phyrexian Arena?
I was not playing that one. I was most certainly playing the...
It's more along the lines of, I believe that Justin purchased the black EDH deck of Nyxalis of the Black Oath.
I did.
And that card happened to be in it.
I did. It's true.
So it's like a 2-for-1.
Yeah.
What do you got over there? Are we reducing its casting cost at all?
By Oon Mana.
Delve 2. Oh, we played top lands.
Oh, okay. Yeah. I was like, that's 5 lands. But yes.
Got to die?
Yeah.
Alrighty.
I'll block.
I will too.
No, he's not.
Steve.
Steve. 26.
6. All right. Is it my turn?
Go ahead.
It's all you, boo boo. 25.
Yep. What do we do here? What's in the graveyard?
I've got nothing.
I got an expedition map.
An expedition map.
Nothing.
Expedition
nothing.
Map.
Expedition map. Nothing.
Still just an expedition.
Want to check one more time?
Okay.
The screech is gone. Screech has been gone. They went to battle.
It's Screech to slash Scrot.
All right. I am going to cast my General.
There it is.
I will remove Sheldred. It will become a copy of Sheldred, and it'll have 0 plus 1 counters on it.
So it's Sheldred.
It's just Sheldred.
So okay.
So I'm going to set Sheldred on top
since
of it.
Since it's exiled.
Since it's exiled, I will not be able to use it again.
Acceptable.
I want to play a Wasteland and target a Phyrexian Tower. So we can get that out of here.
You have
get that out
made
of here.
Me upset.
I need you not to be able to sacrifice your cards.
You don't sound
And
upset.
John, you attack me first.
Yeah,
so
it.
We're going to attack you.
With everything?
With everything.
Oh, wow. You want to trigger your Sidisi?
You didn't hold back last turn.
You attacked him for 6.
I did.
I'm going to miss.
All right, yeah, I'll take it.
This is no zombies.
9.
Yes.
All right. 34 for John?
Yep.
And I'm done.
My right, so upkeep, I have to...
Sacrifice a creature.
Yeah.
What will it be?
Can I have another die? I would like to put a feather counter on another one of my creatures.
He's probably going to keep doing that.
Unless we can make him
bird.
Get rid of these. How about I give you these two?
That's probably
that's a
good
really
idea.
Good idea.
All right.
You should have brought coins, pennies, to denote feather counters.
You're not wrong. I would like to draw some magic cards.
Oh my gosh.
Who has birds in play? Anybody have birds in play?
Hold on. Praetor.
I'm lying.
Naga Shaman. Zombies.
I have an enchantment guy.
Naga. You're not going to draw any cards.
You don't have any birds?
Right, no,
I'm
going
to draw 6.
You have 6? Cheating.
Yeah, seriously.
It would have been 7 if I hadn't made him sacrifice the one.
It's true.
That card's good.
That such full grip.
We're back in it. If we were ever out of it.
In it to win it-ish.
Ish is correct.
Yes.
Alright.
Yeah, you got lots of cards over there, John.
Let's play a Soul Catcher here.
Oh, man.
Remember a bird those, is put into your graveyard?
I know it, now. I know what that card does, but for those of us that don't...
Whenever a bird is put into a graveyard from play, in my graveyard from play, yes. Put a feather counter on Soul Catcher's area.
All it becomes birds, a 3-1.
All birds get +1/+1 for each feather counter on Soul Catcher's area. So this card does work for everyone.
It does.
If you guys have birds, and it has a feather counter on it. You'll end up with
find my zombie bird.
Oh man, I'm playing Birds of Paradise.
I'll have to dig for that.
Oh man, that is a bird.
It is a bird. It could be a quite large bird at some point in the game.
Okay, well then, play a land of scry.
All the scry
temples all around.
It's a good card. All right, looks like we're gonna get some action in here. Are you going to keep attacking me if I attack you again?
Well, yes.
You're
going to
keep attacking you regardless.
Are you going to keep attacking me if I stop attacking?
Look at his eyes.
I trust you.
Hey, do you remember when I trusted Steven that one time? He lied right to my face.
He's a liar. So there's that.
Are you asking me if I'm capable of lying? I am capable.
No, you're capable. You are a liar.
Do you do it constantly during these games?
No.
Yes.
No.
Yeah.
I'm not going to.
Hold on.
I'm not going after the creature with the guys with 1/1 flying over there.
I'm just saying.
So all of these guys are probably going to attack. I'm just debating on where.
I'll block.
You should attack him because he's very quick to I'll block. And then he won't have any creatures in play.
Neither will I. All my guys are 3-1.
Well, don't attack with this one.
3-1. 3-1. 3-2.
Yeah, but after that, guess what they won't be anymore.
Yes, they're huge then. They're not wrong.
Yeah. These birds?
But then I'll just keep blocking.
No, you won't. Because then he'll overwhelm you.
You know what?
You can attack me. It's a legitimate thing.
No, we're going to ping off 10. Old Noell.
Yeah.
3, 6, 9, 12. Oof.
That's too many.
23. Hey, remember, you don't have to lose 1 life every upkeep.
That's true. You can target me.
Yeah.
You can target me as
or
well.
Me. I can. I can do that thing.
I have a lot of options.
Upkeep.
34.
You must sacrifice.
Okay. I did.
Was that a bird?
It was not.
No, it was a mere surf.
Surf was up 1 last time.
A mere surf.
Now it's all turf, right?
No.
You got a bunch of flyers.
I have a bunch of flyers. No more surfs. let's see now. I'm going to play CDC.
Something that lets you sacrifice things?
Undead Vizier.
Go figure.
What would you sacrifice? Is it Bitter Blossom?
I can't do that. I'll sacrifice.
We'll allow it.
Used up Singer Autocrat.
Is that cool?
What are you searching for?
Sure. I'm going to search for a card. And then I'm going to put that card into my hand.
What card is it?
It's the card that I'm going to search for.
The card that he's searching
for. How long
for.
Do you think it would take you to search up?
It's probably not going to take that long.
I hope it's more than a minute and 40 seconds.
Yeah, it's unlikely.
God.
And then he'll pass the turn.
Well, the turn, he's done.
It is unlikely. I'm going to put this card into my hand, and I'm going to show the camera after that. But then I'm going to pass the turn.
All right. So I have some triggers.
Do you do?
I'm going to stack them in such a way that...
You draw your card first?
I'll draw my card first.
It's active, then non-active,
so, this is
so
what,
you'll have to sacrifice
this is
first.
What I search for.
Oh, right.
Yeah.
You'll still get your trigger.
You will still get your trigger.
It's a good card.
Yeah, you still get to draw your card.
My personal opinion.
22.
I didn't just make that up, right? That's correct.
That sounds right, because it's active and then not around
active.
Non-active ones.
And non-active
but I get to draw a card from that.
Was that a bird?
And then it was a demon, but he's got wings.
So close.
But he's got horns, too.
We'll give you a complimentary token. If you lose two birds of my choice, you get
two tokens. Of your choice.
You get two tokens for two birds of my choice dying.
Do I get two bird tokens?
Yeah, you can use two bird tokens. I'll let you get two counters. Mm. You'll be tapped out then, right? Then we can really bring the pain.
Maybe.
I know who I have to bring the pain to now, though.
The guy with all the creatures?
Well, the guy who can't block my Swamp Walking Legend.
That's a good one.
The only one you can block, I have Herborg.
Okay, I just have to get this show
it's
on
great.
The road.
Uh-oh. There's a show about to be going on the road.
It's a Decree of Pain?
Or roads.
It's a Decree of Pain?
Don't be a Decree of Pain.
Close. It's Decree of Pain.
It's in Yurik's Wake.
That's fine.
What does that do?
Destroy all creatures you don't control and all planeswalkers you don't control.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Six.
I thought I was going to do something crazy.
Nah, not too crazy.
I'm going to hand you these zombies back because it's highly unlikely that I go back to the DC rate.
Was a little,
I agree. It's obnoxious.
Yeah.
You can bring it at me. I feel like I deserve it.
You did swing.
I did swing free 12.
So that is coming at you.
How much? 29? And you got 4 Tasker damage.
Yeah, 4 Tasker. And that's coming 4 to 30
damage. I got me a 29.
I got a 29.
I did 34 last time. Did I miss something?
30, oh, it's 30. Only 4. It's only
attack for 15.
It's
4. 30.
Yeah. No, it's a 4.
We make
five.
The mistake that it's a 5-5, five, five, but it's a 4-5.
I do. No, it's no zombie fish.
All right. It's no zombie fish. I will take one
about that.
And go to 24.
Told you, about 45 mana later, that card will resolve.
Yeah. Well, yeah, 9 of it here. Yeah. So
I tapped out last turn.
He
tapped
six.
Out the turn. Yeah, like I said,
wait, it's 6 and 5. I have 11. Yeah. Oh, man, it's going to be way more than 45.
Yeah,
that's 20 between Jeremy and I.
Yeah.
I cast Tasker to geez, it's like 60. 60 mana spent later.
Frantic search?
Oh, how frantic.
He's searching real hard.
Discard Moldrifter and Temple of Mystery.
The temple that he almost cheated into play.
Almost.
That's
very
true.
So close.
Almost.
So close.
Doesn't count. Play a compulsion.
Okay.
And a Sakura.
I do like that. I do
not
like Sakura.
Way,
try about her. It you sacrifices itself, and I'm into things sacrificing themselves.
All right, there's no upkeep abilities. All right, upkeep triggers, right?
Nope.
No, but your birds are huge.
They are monstrous.
They will be. All thanks to you, Steven.
Once he gets them into play.
He did it.
All thanks to you, Steven.
He definitely did that.
You forced his hand, though.
Yeah. It's play Urza's Incubator. When it comes into play, I choose a creature type.
Zombie.
Zombie.
Bird.
Oh.
Bird.
Did not expect that.
Bird.
Shaman.
Come on.
Human shaman.
Yeah.
I don't know. I got nothing over here.
God.
There we go.
All right. Wait. Cloud Chaser Raven. When it comes into play, destroy target enchantments.
You don't want these?
No, I don't care about
that. That card's better.
It is, but not for what's going
on. This one's probably way better.
Two blue. Let's play Mistraven and bounce that Tasigur out of here.
Bounce it.
Woo! Yeah, return it to my hand. Ready. Yeah. You can choose to put it in your hand or put it in your hand.
I misplayed that turn by playing that land. That's okay. Go ahead.
Here we are.
I have 16 powers worth of creatures. All of a sudden.
And I am going to play Cabal Coffers.
Mm. They're all swamps.
All swamps.
Matt checks out. Yeah. So he has six, nine mana. All right, we're going to add six.
We're going to play a
Weep.
Okay, two left.
Weep of Erebus.
We're going to activate the
Weep for a Phyrexian Gargantuan.
Phyrexian Gargantua. I'm going to go to 33. Draw two.
One, a two.
Those are really big.
They're
do
huge.
That?
You see how big they are?
Jeremy, you're the only one I can gain life off of.
That is definitely correct. He's not getting any life.
I'm going to 37.
You get four off of me.
Jeremy.
Not first strike, right?
18, right?
That's true.
I mean, they exile anyway, even if this dies, so.
Yeah.
You're going to get my licks in. You're at 19?
18. 18?
I was at 22. Okay, 18. I believe you. I'm done after that.
You picked on the birds, and now look how big they are.
You started from the bottom, and you're still at the bottom. Drake would not be proud.
Stop thinking like an artificer, Urza, and start thinking like a father.
Nah. If they make a magic movie, I hope that's in the trailer.
Supposedly making one.
That seems like...
What, the Drake comment?
No, that.
Drake in the magic movies?
That would be great, too.
Showing all the planeswalkers before their spark.
You go five, increasing ambition.
Ooh. Was that cast from your graveyard?
It was not currently cast from my graveyard. Currently? Look at him. Think he's hot stuff. Because he can cast stuff in his graveyard. Well, let me tell you something.
Tell me something.
Well, I got to think of it, but once I do, I'm going to tell you. I'm going to tell you that thing.
I'm waiting.
Keep waiting, but you're not going to like it.
So much face. That's all I'm hearing right now.
I'm just saying, eventually...
How do I have no hand again? I just drew like six cards two turns ago.
You did.
Got to get that one back.
Don't worry, just start sacrificing your 8-8 birds.
That won't happen anytime soon. Unless you guys make me.
Yeah, I was like, don't tempt me.
Yeah, you make me. I'll draw a card.
Did you find your card?
I did find my card. Shuffled. I'm going to play my land for the turn, which is also a Cabal Coffers.
It's a little better for him.
Interesting. Yeah, he can make many mana.
I think that's what he's going to do.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And we're going to...
Going to...
Tap one more, you can cast Leveler.
Going to...
Spend 8.
Spend 8.
Flash that back.
Oh, man. That's so crazy.
So that counts as one crazy. Search. That counts as one search.
This that's, all counts as one
yeah,
search? All together.
Yeah. If you search for Cabal Coffers to redo that...
Well, that says 2. The first one's 1, and that one's 1 more search.
So I'm going to get this.
We feel like this search for 2. I feel like all 3 of these searches constitute one search now.
All together. No,
this one's 1. He's got to get 2 cards in under 40 seconds.
If there's only some way to distract him. You sure you want that one? I think he's pretty positive.
Oh, man.
I know what I'm about.
He looked at me in the face. I think he's pretty positive that he wants that one.
All right. So that was 2 cards, hopefully, yes. In under 40 seconds. Pretty sure it was.
No, looking at my stopwatch here, it says you were at 40.7 seconds, which is over.
Your stopwatch is really bad.
For you me. Mean because it's a piece of paper, it's not really a stopwatch?
Yes.
Okay.
All right. I have one...
One mana.
One mana floating. And I will do something I don't really want to do.
I'm going to respond and draw a card. Okay. I'm going to discard this Burning Catacombs. I'm also going
to blow this up.
No, they're all small again.
Yes.
Small again. Those were very big birds.
I know. Can I have an elephant or a beast? Excuse me.
Man,
you could have blew up the incubator.
I have a turtle. You can have a turtle.
All your birds are out.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You say. Oh,
big man with 8 cards in his hand.
Big man with 8 cards.
Is in his hand.
Correct. So upset about that. They were so big. Discard Evolving Wilds and pass.
Upkeep. I will go to 23.
23. Don't you forget it. That Phyrexian Arena. Hanging around. I have a secret to tell you guys. I can't get rid of it.
Your mana block deck can't deal with enchantments? So you wouldn't have been able to deal with Soulcatcher's area?
Absolutely not.
Thanks. Thanks a lot.
Not even.
I'm sorry.
Not I'm going to cast my general.
Close.
32 life over there. Again. I come down to 2 attacks.
I'm going to cast my general again. Yeah. This time, however.
It's going to be a Secret Art Elder.
This time, however.
+1/+1
It's going to be a Sepulchral Primordial.
Okay.
And it's going to have copies equal to the power of Sidisi, a Brood Tyrant on it. Because I get to do that. So I have 4 +1/+1 counters.
Super interesting.
And then Sepulchral Primordial is going to trigger.
Because it's exiled.
It's exiled. That's what it does. Exiles 2 creatures.
Oh. Which creatures did you exile?
I did mine. And then his Sidisi. So it's +4/+4. And then starting with John. What do I want? I want this. We'll take Avon Mimeomancer, and we will get some Surfs.
Sure.
And I'm sure we're going to take a Blood Gift Demon out of yours.
Go figure.
Yeah.
Ball Double scenes. Arena. Surfs up again.
And I'm done.
I'm very happy at what just happened there, Jeremy.
You'd be less happy when your feather counters start being good for me.
What are you talking about?
No. Well, if you had it in play now, I could make birds. It turns them into birds, right? I wish that was still in play.
Oh,
no. No.
3/1
It's just 3/1 It doesn't make them birds.
Correct. Just, they're already birds in John's deck.
That's right.
Yeah, I know.
They don't need to turn into birds.
This has Intimidate, by the way.
I'm not scared.
So that you two can block it.
I'm not scared in the slightest bit. Okay. Yep. Yeah, I didn't want that to happen.
Well, I don't like what's happened here.
I equally don't like it.
I'm sorry. Oh, you're gonna be.
Oh, okay. Well, I can tell you that I can deal with this.
Oh, well, that's good. Good. All right. If you can deal with that, then I'll leave you alone.
Okay. You can deal with this. I can deal with
you. You can deal with all of that.
I can deal with this.
Creatures.
Yeah,
the creatures. So it's also going to kill my creatures, but that's okay.
If that's the way it's going to be, Jeremy, you're going to have
that's the way the cookie crumbles
going forward after that.
Probably.
Well, I'm going to draw about 6 million cards this coming turn.
Six million.
A couple.
That is a lot.
Plus a couple of triggers.
So that's going to be,
I guess it's
X2. Because it's 2. It's reduced.
Yeah. Well, yeah, you're getting...
Getting X equals 2, essentially. That's what I want to do.
Yes. If you're paying 6 mana, yeah.
There's so many choices. What do you got in there for that whip? Nothing anymore?
Nothing now.
Okay.
I've officially removed
the whipped out.
So he gets 2 feather counters. Only a die for them. That's fine. That'll work.
Yeah. Well, he has a...
So they get +2/+2. All birds.
All birds.
Burbs.
No matter the bird, no matter the owner, right? That's from Invasion, so.
Yes, all birds. All right. Justin, you have a lot of life.
29. Not as much now.
4, 8, 11?
Oh, 26. Back in,
I would have blocked for you, but I can't do that.
You wouldn't have.
No, I would have. The Surfs.
Yeah, it's sure.
Silly.
It's the kind of thing they're for, you know?
All right.
Done.
Yeah.
All right. Draw my card, form a turn.
Just in case somebody wants to do something mean.
So, if I play a land, I can make 7/+4, so I can have 11 mana. That seems okay. Seems all right. I think I'm going to play this Strip Mine. You're fine.
Don't worry. You have nothing to fear.
I feel as though he's probably going to target Cabal Coffers.
You don't know that.
He's his own.
Ooh.
Is that last priest of the Blood Rite?
Priest of the Blood Rite. Not priest of the Blood Wrong. Priest of the Blood Rite.
What else happens with him?
At the beginning of your upkeep, you lose 2 life.
If you don't have a demon?
No, just no, if he's in play.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Don't you try to get tricksy with me.
Is that a bird?
It's not.
Okay.
It was a demon.
Good.
So I had 7 mana. I used 2. I'll use 2 more. I'm going to play Disciple of Bolas.
I think we're sacrificing Priest of the Blood Rite.
I'll sacrifice Priest of the Blood Rite.
So you gain
2. Go to 28, and I'll draw 2.
It's all right.
It's okay. Jeremy, are you going to use your powers for good or evil?
Say he's going to kill all the creatures, so for evil.
Both. I can deal with that. That's fine. I'll pass.
Just lets him untap with it. That is a lot of mana.
You're the one with all the stuff.
I'm not the one playing Villainous Wealth.
Yeah, Villainous Wealth. That's not what we need. He ain't going to win the game with Villainous Wealth.
Well, it's for a lot.
That's different. Don't be a liar now.
Yeah, don't be a liar.
Don't be a liar now. People to the left of me lie frequently.
He can have 15 mana, so he could fill this well for 12.
That's not one of the games.
16, yeah, he could play a land this turn.
Yeah, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16.
That's how it works.
Yes.
Because I have a temple.
Yes.
That finger counting.
So, 9. Strawberry.
I will respond. I would like to draw a card.
Yep. How many am I getting?
You could have warned me. I would have drawn more cards. Gained more life.
Oh, you're getting 3 from me.
I actually drew this.
Okay.
This is in your exile pile. But
exile?
Fair enough.
About the same.
You got 3 from me. 3.
Why is that exile?
4 or 5, right?
Mimeoplasm.
Oh, no, it's not. It's not. I naturally reanimated. I'm wrong.
Okay. How many did you get?
You got 3 serfs. Sepulchre Primordial, an Avonmind thing, Avonmiomancer, and a Singer Autocrat. So 3.
And 3?
Yes, yeah, so 3, 7?
7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12.
Yeah, a creature from each of you plus my creature, yes.
Draw a bunch of cards there, Jeremy.
2.
Maybe he'll deck.
4.
Yeah, maybe he will.
5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. That's too many.
Yeah, you should have just nipped that one out. Only because it hurt.
Just you.
No, it hurts us all because he has 40 million cards in his hand.
He also only has 18 life.
It's very true. I do only have 18
life. If he only had to pay 1 life for each card in his hand, I would agree with you. But
so I have 1 black floating currently.
Maybe. No, math checks out, he does.
Yeah.
Maybe I just wanted to say maybe.
Maybe you did.
Command tower. Soul ring with the 1 black.
Yeah, you're short on mana, thank goodness. Thank goodness for that soul ring.
Thank goodness for that soul ring indeed.
Again.
Stay away.
We're both fighting for good. Okay.
In that case?
Yeah, I'm a healer.
Good.
It says it right in the title.
Yeah.
Heretically.
Yeah, don't ignore what you think you've seen.
Yeah.
Alright, we will go with...
My powers of necromancy are currently weak.
my birds don't want to go to war.
They do not.
They've gotten rid of all of them.
2, 4.
What's wrong about this? This is in your graveyard. I just reanimated with the Sepulchre Primordial.
I'll play that.
Tasigur?
Tasigur.
Okay.
And then...
Saved from his own thing that he cast.
You know what? Let's all have a little fun.
I like fun.
I've been having fun.
Let's all have a little fun. Tempt with discovery.
What are you tempting me?
Tempting offer. Search my library for a land card, put it on the battlefield. Each opponent may search their library for a land card and put it on the battlefield. For each one, I get another life.
Yeah, I'm going to do that.
So I get 3 right now. Are you searching?
They come into play tapped?
They just come into play.
Okay. Yes, I'm searching.
Yeah, why not?
4 total.
So I get 1?
Yeah. basic, right?
No, just land.
Just land. Are you tempted?
It is quite the offer. I'm going to get Crypt of Agony.
I'm going to get Strip Mine.
I like what I hear. Yeah.
Well, I mean, we let him get one in response for all of these, so.
Get Wimber's Heights.
Okay.
All right. I'm going to get Treadship Reef, Crown Catacomb, Island, Pajuk Cabal.
Woo-wee!
Ooh. That one looks like it hurt.
Strip Mine.
So hide away.
Hide him away.
Top four.
And then
you hide that.
You hide it real good. There it is, hidden. Didn't even see it. Mm-mm. Did it so fast.
I will pass the turn. I have to discard a bunch.
Many?
Yeah, I have to discard many.
Time has finally come.
Maybe. There's plenty of cards at the graveyards for me to reanimate. So.
Oh, no, I just meant the fact that you're spent spell smiling.
Clever Impersonator, Torrent Elemental in general.
Torrent Elemental? That does something from the graveyard, doesn't it?
It does something from exile, actually.
Oh, okay.
Whenever it says, pay three black, green, put Torrent Elemental from exile onto the battlefield tapped.
Okay. What does it do when it's in play?
Simply, it's a flyer, 3/5 flyer, and when it attacks, tap all creature defending black green controls.
Okay. I'm good.
Quite good. Is it my turn?
Yes. No.
So upkeep. We're going to Ancestral Visions first.
I think I was about halfway.
I'm going to lose a life. We're going to 22. I'm going to draw four cards, and then I'll draw for my turn.
Okay, so you're at 22. We definitely cast 100 mana.
Yeah, well over 100 mana.
Yeah. Now I'm going to draw for my turn.
Well, you can't play Ancestral Recall.
I just did.
About put me to sleep casting it.
Remember to use those strip mines for good, Stevie.
Sorry for how long that took. That was a little bit
much. Yeah, sometimes you gotta do your thing. Sometimes before you die.
12 cards.
What?
Before you die. Sounds like you're targeting them.
Strip mine, Cabal Coffers.
Which sure. One?
Yes.
Okay.
Yep.
Right. Seems right.
Yep, makes a lot of sense.
I'm gonna play Oracle and we'll die. It's good.
Yeah.
Opal Palace. I haven't played a land this turn. I will cast Life from Law.
Okay.
I'm going to get back Strip Mine. First land for the turn. Strip Mine. Destroy Cabal Coffers.
Hey, all the Cabal Coffers are gone.
We'll just go ahead and get them all out.
I like it. It's a haven, Stevie. You can't kill it.
I need a black mana, so... Put this in play. I have an Urborg in play. And a black. We're going to reanimate.
Would you like animate?
Cloud Chaser?
I think I just got Blood Kit Demon and... Oh, no, I got the other two guys. Clever Impersonator.
I'm going to choose Clever Impersonator.
Okay.
Interesting.
Clever Impersonator is going to be a Phoenix.
Okay. All right.
Hmm.
You currently I lost four, five, four life.
Two,
four
three, life. Four, five.
It's five, right?
Well, what do you mean?
It's five.
It's four.
He
reanimated a clever impersonator.
Oh,
yes,
yeah,
but
yeah,
I'm saying your devotion is five.
Yeah, yeah, no. We're talking about how much life.
Four, five.
Steve, is it 18?
Yeah, I'm at 18.
You sure you didn't want the Haven Cloud Chaser?
Could blow up that whip, man.
I'm fine. He can have his whip.
You all done?
Yeah.
I'm not whipping much.
It's fine if he has his whip. He just both can't have Cabal Coffers.
Why not? What about just one of us? And that'd be me.
Well, because you could have killed Cabal Coffers and you didn't, so you got punished for it.
I needed mana, Steven.
You didn't even use it.
I needed it to cast spells.
Sounds like you're lying.
I'm not lying.
Smells a lot like lying.
Well, so, Steven, you know, you cast spells more than one turn of the game.
That's not a... It's a bird person. Guardian.
Bird person?
Bird guardian.
Hydromorph Gull.
It's a 3/3 flying creature.
Pay a blue, sacrifice a counter-target spell that targets one or more creatures I control.
I like it.
Won't be doing that.
But fortunately, we're not going to be playing... Steve, you have a lot of good permanents out.
Yeah, let's kill it.
Do I?
Yeah, you have a lot of them. Like, a lot.
I just killed two Cabal Coffers, and you're going to tase me?
Yeah, I'm going to tase you a little bit. I'm just going to play an Oblivion.
On?
That's the question. Now I got to look. Does he have an Oracle Moldiah? You have a clever impersonator. What does Phoenix do?
You can
target player puts creatures you control have tap. Target player puts the top X cards of his or her library into her graveyard.
I'm just going to take this Phoenix. Yeah, okay. I think those other two, like taking away a draw source, doesn't make much of a difference.
That's really rough though, because when that comes back, he can just
Get something else.
Something else.
What if nothing's in play?
What if nothing else is there?
Yeah.
I don't think we'd play it that way, but.
I'm going to
it's possible.
Play one that way.
Play an Azurius Chancery.
Yep.
Play it that way where nothing else was there. I was like, I don't think I'd play it that way, but.
But what if there's no other permanents?
Send it back.
What if there was like an Akrama's Vengeance?
Oh no.
There's only one player that
has that. I don't have it.
However, I didn't take away your ability to get mana out of your graveyard. How many creatures are in your graveyard currently?
So it doesn't do anything.
Oh, well good. Exactly what you deserve.
Neither does my Hydromorph Golf, if it makes me feel any better. I could sacrifice it if you try to target it. That's in case one of you tries to steal it.
What if it's not with a spell? What's with an ability?
Just target spell. Okay. Just spell. Mm-hmm. You can have it with an ability. It'll probably be...
You got a whole grip of cards. Don't act like you don't have stuff.
Yeah, well, it all costs a lot of mana that I can't use.
This is black spells. They can't cost too much. I got Bajuka Bog this
What game. Does that even mean? Black spells. They have the lowest converted mana cost.
They have the lowest converted mana cost of all spells.
Yeah, you heard it. You heard it here first, folks. He says, did after you know I cast, that the only kind of water that should fly through the air is rain?
Decree of Pain in Garrick's Wake. I've cast both of these this game, but they have the lowest converted mana cost.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Well, right. You could have cast Damnation. Alternatively,
I could have.
How much did that cost?
It costs too much money to put in my deck.
Nether Spirit?
It costs too much money to put in my deck.
It costs the same amount
I'm
going to
cast Dread Return.
That has to be from your graveyard. Right?
Yeah, it has to be from mine.
That's all right.
You're going to get a priest?
I'm going to target Singer Autocrat.
Okay.
Is that all fine, well, and good?
Yes.
All right. I'm going to tap 3. I'm going to play Liliana, Heretical Healer. All well and good?
That is correct.
Yeah, I guess so. I'm going... to sacrifice Dread Return, I'm going to sacrifice these. This is going to get exiled.
So we have a Liliana trigger now, don't we?
Liliana trigger. Mm. Mm. And I'm going to target Priest of the Blood Rite.
Each player discards a card. Target non-legendary. Alright, whatever.
Oh, I don't know if he's doing that.
He can't. It comes back at...
I can do it immediately.
It does immediately. Yeah. It flips over now.
Yeah, all right, so are we good?
Yeah, sure.
I don't know. He's the one with open mana. I have
4, but I'm not doing it.
Oh, I'll say I have 4 swamp. Priest I can't do anything on 4 swamp. I feel like me and Jeremy aren't playing counter spells.
I'm not either.
Okay.
I might have like 1.
Yeah, I think I'm
like going to have everybody discard a card.
I wonder if it's going to be that snow-covered plains that I just picked up previously.
Probably. Okay, we're ready?
Sire. It will not. I'll
discard reassembling
skull. Choose swamp.
Reassembling skeleton.
I'm going to pass the turn after that.
Could you use that and not in my direction? It's kind of scaring me every time.
Well, I don't need to use it anymore.
Okay. Made me.
I didn't make you do anything. You Bajuka Bogged me and got taste in response.
How many Urborgs are in play?
One.
Yeah, just Stevens. Smart. I don't need Urborg anymore.
Nor do I.
My Cabal Coffers is no more.
Any flyers over there? You do have one flyer.
I do. They all fly. I don't have any just soldiers.
Are you killing my permanents again? Okay.
Hey, sure glad you got mine out of there. That was great.
I did it with Life from the Wild.
Yeah, he can do it again, is what he's saying.
Or Justin could just do it. He doesn't care about the integrity.
You
of the
literally just told me you had Life from the Wild strip mine. Why would I use my only strip mine that I could possibly have in my deck?
Hey, I'm just going to let him globetrot.
You could have Crucible.
But I don't. I wish I did.
4 to play Splendid Reclamation.
That's everybody or just you?
All land cards from your graveyard to the battlefield tax. Mm-hmm.
Would have liked that.
Awkward.
Yeah.
I'll see. I'm just going to let him globetrot, so.
I mean, you could literally respond right now before he gets all these lands into play and destroy his Cabal Coffers.
So.
Then he gets them back.
I could kill it in response.
Yeah. That's how that works. Yeah.
You'd be tapped.
Anyways.
You don't make any sense.
It's a lot of mana over there.
So yeah, I know. It's even more now.
He could just respond and still just...
Wait, no.
5, 6.
Remember when I asked you about Herborg?
12, 13. 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20.
You have 20 manias.
Yeah.
Okay, just making sure.
25.
25 just to be safe.
25 just to be safe. I'm going to wealth for 22.
Who are you targeting?
Yeah, birds. Yours is probably the most synergistic.
Well, the only... What is it? I was going to say, you can definitely cast me in justice spells.
Yeah, I can... All my land spells.
You can cast everybody's spells.
Holy Christ.
Yeah.
Oh, we didn't care about Villainous Wealth, though. Wasn't good.
I didn't care about Villainous Wealth.
I mean, he gets 25 birds. That's a lot of birds.
It is a lot of birds. I'm going to go...
With Steven. Me.
Steven.
All right.
So 20... It's actually 23. No, 20. Because I had 25 mana total, so it's 22.
4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16... 19, 20, 21, 22.
All right. And you get all non-lands.
Non-lands.
I can cast.
And then it just exiles everything else, right?
Yeah.
So I'm going to exile over half my deck.
I hope your whole deck gets exiled.
He just did get most of it.
All right. So there's these.
Steven, you should have had more lands on the top.
We're going to go...
So many options.
I'm just going to probably not cast a couple of these since they don't do anything. Or do very little. So I'm going to say we're not going to cast probably any of those right now. probably not going to cast that either. Or that.
All right.
So we'll go Chromatic Lantern. Get some extra.
Hey.
So I used to be in it on this side.
I just assumed you were saving your mana for who knows what.
You were. Saving that strip mine.
Yeah.
I tried. That was my contribution.
I know.
This is the really weird one, right?
Yeah.
It's just anime.
It's just anime dead. You're not casting it with.
Yeah, it's just not. Cast it.
It's anime dead from any graveyard.
Yeah, but he has a Rise of the Dark Realms in there. Yeah.
Ah.
That's kind of why I was.
He's probably going to do that.
Mm-hmm.
Let's do this. And.
You can do everything you need to do and resolve your triggers
now,
at the end.
What does Villainous Wealth say?
It says target opponent exiles top X cards of his or her library. You may cast any number of non-land cards with converted mana cost X or less from among them without paying their mana cost.
Should I do it all at once?
I don't believe so, but I'm just going to resolve.
I just said he could just do it all and then resolve it all.
Well, I mean, the reason I'm asking is because if you're casting Rise of the Dark Realms and you're casting Shriek Maul, you're not going to get back Oracle and we'll die. It's just going to die after the Rise of the Dark Realms. Because Shriek Maul is a trigger, or Rise of the Dark Realms is the
No, he gets
resolving.
To cast them one at a time. He doesn't have to cast them.
Oh, I see what you're saying.
I know he casts them one at a time, but the triggers won't resolve until the card Villainous Wealth resolves, which involves casting all of those cards.
I see what you're saying. Yeah, you're right. So that I do not get
It's going to die.
It's all going
to
die.
It's going to die, but he's just not going to be able to get it back.
We're going to Clever Impersonate.
Hmm.
And for Exiting Metamorph.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Eternal Witness.
All right.
I'm not going to play that because I don't want to keep sacrificing lands. I'm going to play Demonic Factor Fiction and Rise of the Dark Realms as well. So here's all my creatures. I get a lot of tokens.
You have many tokens.
Is it 4 Hornets, right?
20 tokens, 4 Hornets.
search my library for a land card. Basic forest card, reveal it, put it into your hand, and shuffle.
Surfs up again.
Surfs up everywhere.
You also have a Disciple Bolas trigger. Should you be interested in such things.
You also get to scry 3, blow up an enchantment, and bounce creature.
Oh, man.
I wonder whose permanence he will target.
I have an idea.
I did, too. He's 3 for 3 on me so far. So.
All right. So,
let's make it 4 for 4.
What else do I have? I have
Disciple Bolas.
Disciple Bolas.
Triggers.
You said scry 3.
Scry 3, bounce creature, destroy enchantment.
I have to do these ones.
Well, yeah, you gotta do these first. Yes. So this is resolved. That can go in Steven's graveyard.
All right, I'm going to go Demonic Tutor first.
Okay, this is,
do
this
I get it back if he casts it?
Yeah, it goes in your graveyard. If I cast it, it goes in your graveyard.
Yeah, it goes in your graveyard as part of resolving.
Okay.
As a spell. Is that not what it says?
I don't know.
It doesn't say. It just says you may cast it.
I'm just going to take a old glancy.
Pretty sure they just stay exiled.
You may cast any number of non-land cards. No, they don't.
Exiled this way.
So they go.
Well,
they're still exiled, but they don't. Just because you cast something from exile doesn't mean it stays in exile. It goes in your graveyard as the part of resolving.
And I'm also going to have 2 Eternal Witness triggers. I'm going to get back.
Fill in a swell.
I wonder.
And a basic Plains.
I don't have any basics at all.
That was a joke. Not a good one, but it was one.
It was a joke. I'll go with Garrick's Wake, just in case.
All right, this is dead now, right?
I haven't decided that.
It's true, he hasn't decided. Fact or fiction.
Let's go with Suarez.
Ha! That doesn't do anything.
Alright, well, that doesn't do anything. He's right. That's your one counter spell.
Yeah.
Life of Them does something if I kill his Kowal Coffers again.
Definitely does.
We could have just stopped it altogether. You could have did it. You could have did it.
I did try to.
No, really try to.
How do I protect against
your Urborg?
Your Urborg is the reason all this is happening. Yeah.
It's true. So what do you have in your hand?
As soon as he activated, he could have strip mine and
respond. You can't respond. It's inactive. It's not. It's a mana ability.
You are aware that I have Villainous Wealth.
To pay mana into it.
When he cast Splendid Reclamation, I could have killed your Urborg.
Yes.
And out of spite for Steven, I didn't do it.
Correct.
Scry 3, right?
Yes.
Because spite is the most powerful emotion in
character. It is very powerful. Hold on. And you get the Destroy an Enchantment and Bounce Creature.
And Shriek Maw, one of our creatures.
I think Shriek Maw one of those birds.
Destroy an Enchantment, eh?
Yep.
And get to Bounce Creature.
Yep.
And you get to Bounce a Creature, eh?
Yep.
And you get a Shriek Maw creature. A.
If you try hard enough, you can kill one more of my things.
Huh?
I said if you try hard enough, you can kill one more of my things.
You also get to go get a basic land and put a bunch of 1/1s into play for Avengers and a car.
He's already got them.
Oh, okay.
There's 20 of them right there.
Okay, cool.
I already got the basic land as well.
Got it.
And put it in my hand.
Got it. Got it.
Well, here we are.
After all is said and done.
Oh, I forgot we were still on a turn. Seems at 14. 4 Tasigur.
I don't think it's going to come down to that.
Probably not.
I would make it come down to that if I were Jeremy.
Alright, I'm going to pass the turn and I'm going to discard.
You took the Dissipate Life Malone pile, right?
Mm-hmm. Okay.
With the retro lander, whatever it is.
The general's pretty bad.
I imagine
right
Finax is
active. I would imagine it's active.
Oh, very much so.
Fortunately for him.
Well, those blue cards down there are green, so.
He can't activate it yet. Because all these creatures are summoned, sick.
They are. Yep, spells that don't do things.
Almost anything. Good.
13?
13 for Steven. Hi, Steven, what you got?
I'm playing with all your toys.
It's fine.
That took a little longer than it should
You're
have.
You're doing it.
That's what Villainous Wealth does.
Yeah, you can do a lot of things. A whole lot of things.
Mm-hmm. That's careful consideration.
Okay.
The main of phases?
You're definitely going to need to carefully consider whatever you're doing.
It's like losing.
You can do that without careful consideration.
You should just cast Master Worm.
I don't have it.
That'd be pretty good, too.
I'm really looking for answers, but
really
I don't
Master
have
Master Worm would be really nice.
I'd really like to draw Master Worm.
That would be the greatest thing ever.
I really love to draw it.
In fact, if I could make you draw cards, I would.
Now, I only have to discard two, but I'm choosing discard three.
Okay. I got a Master Worm, so if you can...
I don't have any way to make you draw cards yet, but...
Steven probably does, but will not do it.
Make you draw cards?
Yeah.
I don't, but I wouldn't do it. You're correct. So, we're just gonna die.
Maybe.
Well, I didn't. I'm going to cast Reclamation Sage.
I don't have anything to kill.
I'm going to get Clever Impersonator, and it's going to be Lord God.
The thing that produces the most amount of tokens?
An embarrassment of riches.
That way, if I draw it, he also dies. Then John and I are going to have a nice little game of Magic.
Yeah. A nice fair game of Magic,
nice
right?
Game of Magic where we're just...
Birds versus a whole bunch of graveyard shenanigans.
I'll choose... Shriek Maw and kill Avenger.
Alright.
You got to Shriek some leaks.
I'm done.
I don't think having this 1/3/3 is going to
get
me.
Yeah, I probably
anywhere.
Want to draw a card.
Probably just going to cash that one in.
Alright. Cash it on in.
That wasn't what I wanted to cash it in for. Nor was that. Well, alright.
Okay.
Hey, you got some mana. Not, it's, oh.
Okay, you got some more mana.
You can cast Kangee and sacrifice it to draw a card.
I can do that. Got that one on lock. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
You know what, Justin? What way Justin Parnell hates to die from?
Milling.
Milling.
Hmm.
Well, now, fortunately for Justin, I'm a nice person, and your tokens can't get bigger to really, what? Really affect what? Him right now.
That's what I have, all right?
Yeah. No, I was talking to Steven. Steven said he was a nice person.
Oh, sure.
I mean, I did a nice thing
he's
for
nice
you.
He's nice to you right now.
Go ahead.
What? Right when did you do the nice thing for me? Was
when I
not paying
you?
Attention?
Was he asleep? Was
when he can only mill you for 20 cards here instead of 40.
I'm going to... He can mill me for a lot more than that.
No, I'm talking about with this stack.
Just for the stack. Just the stack.
Oh!
Yeah.
Just the stack.
That try to help you. Yeah, I tried to help you.
26.
Help me.
I'm going to draw.
Was a mascot.
Not a mascot. Unfortunately.
This doesn't let me target you. I wish it would.
Hey.
I also wish that would.
Will you want this to all discard a card? I'll discard a card.
Probably. I've been ready to discard a card.
Probably not going to happen. What's the biggest thing?
It's probably his Cabal Coffers.
No, the biggest creature.
No, probably his Urborg.
Probably his Urborg.
The creature. If you could say a creature
Tasigur,
that was big.
Tasigur or Phanax.
You can't kill Phoenix. If you could remove Phoenix,
it'd
be great.
He might be indestructible.
He might.
You could, or
okay.
Could RFG that one.
Well, outside of Phoenix.
Okay.
Probably Tasigur.
So it's like, 5 toughness?
Hornet Queen's a 2/2.
Yeah.
Oh, so. It's 7 toughness. This is 5 toughness.
Yeah.
Yeah, 5 toughness right now is Tasigur.
This Mutilate would be great, too.
Because this was an Eternal Witness, right?
Yeah.
Mutilate. Yeah, both of these are Eternal
I'll witness. Take a Languish right now, all right? I'm just...
Yeah.
Any removal spell that's...
Anything?
For everything.
That's a thing?
Yeah. You can guess Infest, and I'll be pretty happy
with you. 1, 2, 3, 4. I would be okay with...
Just Flame
just,
Tendrils
just
or something.
Uncommon.
Yeah, just... Infest. I'll take Nausea right now. That kills half his board.
It does. It
really
kills
does.
So many things.
It really kills...
All the Hornets, shrivel. All the Saplings, all the Eternal Witnesses.
I could keep naming these cards for days. You could rant to Earth
almost,
right now on his Cabal
kills
therapy.
Kills almost
or Cabal
everything.
Cabal Coffers, yeah.
All right, so... It's really like 2 toughness is the highest like after these two, right?
Yeah, they're all.
I
real
really
tight.
Think
yeah.
that that's the case.
Yeah,
pretty much.
Because yours is hanging around.
Mine's a 6/6.
Yeah.
To be fair, his birds are also huge.
He's big. Boy.
My birds are pretty big.
They're
right
+4/+4. Oh. But I can change it at any moment, thanks to the Haven.
You can, and you
might have to.
You might have to.
And I'm more than willing to.
to fight for the greater good.
Yeah, that. To fight for the greater good. Okay. In that case,
say greater good, like the card the deck is based around is named Villainous Wealth.
Mm.
I don't.
Yeah, you don't have greater good in there, villainous. Do you? Because that seems like it would be.
No.
That's just for the greater good to get the Villainous Wealth.
I can keep going. I can keep naming black spells that give minus to creatures if you need me to. I'll take a Bile Blade at this point.
We take me for
four.
Four?
Four.
What do I have? Two Reclamation Sages?
You have a Shriek Maw.
Shriek Maw and Reclamation Sage.
I will block the zombie token.
Yeah, that's right, you will. 11.
I'll go to 11. Right. I'm going to die anyway. I'm not worried about it.
I'm going to give everything minus two counters.
I think that would have been better the other way, but...
It kills all... So there's nothing that's three. It's like five.
Yes,
the counters stay on Phoenix.
Phoenix gets the counters, and it's based off their toughness, how much you can mill.
I was going to say, okay. In response...
You can't mill.
Didn't you just play that one?
Play all this.
Eternal
Witness, your Cabal Therapy, or your Cabal Coffers into play.
He's still good.
It's just him. You can mill someone for seven.
That works out for you.
Yeah, it's all good for him.
Two?
Come
three?
On. Really?
Four?
Oh, five, no, there it went.
Seven.
Ooh. It's okay.
Maybe he can get it back.
He has a Liliana in play. He can't
get it. Well, it's got to go up a little further before he can get it back.
One time?
Black something.
Black something.
For two?
Yeah.
Now
they stay. Yeah, they're on there. So they can just chill for now. I'll take this.
Why don't you give me a black dice off of these characters?
Okay, so these are feather counters, so he doesn't actually lose the counters from...
Can I get a white? Where's the black?
Yeah.
Black die.
And then we need the black die to denote the negative counters, though.
Those.
Just put a two on all of those.
Yeah. These are all dead as well. These are all dead.
I guess I can use a white. Can you hand me some dice?
Yeah.
Well, John, you should definitely just roll out of there.
Well, he might.
I might.
Give him a chance.
I got plenty of time.
Yeah. He's not.
The problem is, there's a Villainous Wealth in his hand. Just throwing that one back out there.
I understand.
Yeah, so I'm the only one going to get punished by that Villainous Wealth.
Okay.
Maybe.
Well,
so I'm going to tap Crypto Agony for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Where's your general?
Right there. In play, with counters on it.
Yeah, your general is in play.
And I'm going to play Aberrant Overlord, so we'll get four harpies. No, I'll get two harpies.
Two harpies, yeah.
Because this converted mana cost is three, but it's not
black. Not devotion.
That's fine. I actually need a little block in action.
Here. Tap still.
You know? Know what I mean? All right.
I wonder if he could have...
He was
smart. We'll go upstairs. Yeah. Discard for everybody.
And you can see my stuff over plants on here.
Arbork.
As I said, I'll be the one getting punished.
Yeah, you have to be.
Punished.
He has life from
you. You're punished.
Well,
yes.
I need that land. Not the Urborg, I just need the physical land.
Yeah, just like I did when you killed my other two lands. Yeah, I'll pass.
End of your turn.
I killed one land.
Yep.
Kill all those birds.
Oh. They're out of here.
Whew. That's a good one.
Is that a good one?
These are all my graveyard, right?
Of course. Those are all in your graveyard.
Mm. Well,
I have 27 cards, Jeremy, as a FYI.
Just so you know.
Though I don't know what more you can get out of my deck since you got most
27 more cards.
You've taken so much.
You've taken so much. I guess you kind of gave me back a couple of them.
It's okay. You can target me with Quillen as well.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You can also target me.
It's probably better against someone else, but that's fine.
You can target me.
You get my Apex Hawks and my Lieutenant Kiritars.
No, well, if you cast them, they can't.
You're not wrong.
He could also just kill you.
He could.
Heavy is the head, Steven.
He could have.
Heavy is the head.
I don't think he has enough mana.
I don't have enough mana.
They all add mana.
This makes two swamps or three.
What? How many swamps does he have?
Three.
One, two, three. That evolving wilds doesn't do nothing.
Three.
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 Okay, so it adds plus one.
Plus one mana.
Plus one. But evolving wilds could get a swamp if he has one left. That's plus two mana.
Pretty sure I do. What I'm going to do instead.
Don't be instead.
You could have traversed the Uvenwald for an Urborg, but you didn't.
Traverse the Uvenwald.
Traverse.
Three forces. Oh,
now we're Genesis waving.
Oh boy. All these big X spells, I like it.
Maybe not.
Two. That three.
Looks like a Genesis wave to me.
Yeah. He could cast Byra, then we could kick him out of the game, right?
Yes, that's our best case scenario. Cast banned card.
Actually, 7. 6, 7. And I will cast Praetor's Council.
Oh, boy.
Turn all cards from my graveyard to my hand.
Did you tap 7 or 8?
Exile it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, actually. Too many.
Well, you said 7. What am I going to ask?
Yeah, you're right. Turn all cards. Exile this.
Yeah,
I have no
maximum
hand
size.
Get that out
of here so you can't.
Well,
oh, now what are you going to do?
Somebody cast Sudden Impact.
What isn't he going to do?
I don't know.
Is Sudden Impact the most unfortunate card to not have Split Second of all time?
What if it did? That is so sick. You lose.
Flavor fail.
You lose.
Yep, gotcha.
You die.
Gotcha. Die now.
All right. I'm going to touch
you
some people.
No, not this time.
Well, he gets one no matter what, right?
Yeah, I get one no matter what.
Sure.
One.
Why not? I mean, if he's going to get one, that's all he really needs.
If you're going to make me.
Four. 26 cards now.
Count them down, Steven.
The mouth.
Whatever you got, man. Yeah, that's what I got, 26. Did you get an Urborg? Yeah.
Yeah. I think you did.
Yeah.
17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24. Plus I can tap all these. 5, 6, 28.
So you need 29 mana?
How many did you say, 26?
I did 29. Say 26.
You should just do it for all of it.
Yeah.
You show Steven what for.
Just show him his boss. More of those rats.
So it's 24 here. Okay. 25, 26, 27, 28. 29.
2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20,
yeah.
6. I'm just making sure I didn't miscount. It's 26.
26.
What are we casting?
You didn't do anything.
I did stuff.
You tapped a lot of mana.
I did tap
29 of it, to be exact.
So villainous.
Do you have any, like, enters the battlefield effects or, like, spells left, pretty much?
Oh, yeah, he's got spells. He probably has spells left.
Because this is going to go away. Yeah, that's whatever.
All right, I think you probably want to cast this. We'll just say that you want to cast that.
Okay, he can cast whatever he wants to cast. You're not the boss of him.
I think that I'm going to make sure that he kills both of you after I die.
Nah.
Nah. That's not what you want.
What Steven, I want and what's happening are two different things. I wanted him to mill you out. Instead, he milled me out.
Yeah, well. Heavy is the head, Steven. Okay, just remember that.
Evidently.
You're wearing that crown, buddy.
Am I?
It's season 5 now. Season 4 is in a long, long past rearview mirror.
I don't know why.
There
I
it is.
This, but okay.
Oh, Eternal Witness.
You could just lay the permanents in play. Just like put the stack into play.
Yeah.
That'd probably be helpful.
There's all the guys.
There's things.
We're gonna.
Can he overload Cyclonic Rift?
He cannot. Great. Well, there was a shot.
And it's not a good too shot. Late. He gives love a bad name.
It was not a good shot, but it was.
Oh, look, you still got a bunch of good cards.
It was a shot.
Don't feel like I'm going to get through this game with a victory.
I'm right there with you, buddy.
We're not. You're just not going to cast.
Well, I'm putting those aside for now. I don't think I'm going to cast those.
Wow.
I have all these cards to cast.
Yeah, Jerry's doing
these
okay.
These are free, though. Like, you just.
He can do whatever he wants.
He can do whatever he wants.
His body, he can do what he wants. Here.
Oh, destroy the three creatures and draw three cards.
Destroy all those, too.
And all those. It's okay. Destroy target artifact or creature.
Artifact is like...
You keep looking around. I got nothing. Yeah, you've killed exactly. It all.
I got mana.
But he's got mana. There are artifacts and creatures in play to destroy.
You've killed it all. Too. Sure.
Sure.
Bye.
Gonna kill the six.
And it's gone.
I'm going to play all these. Return a card from
trigger.
Do you want to get a basic land out of your deck?
Get a basic land out of my deck. I don't even know if I have a basic land anymore.
I think you.
Oh, I bet you have exactly one because that's how this game would work. That forest there.
Let's see. Let's just see. That was the last one. Probably was.
Oh, I know it was.
Oh, yeah. That's how the game
yeah,
works.
Yeah, that's how the game works. You got, it's always the last one.
You got one. All right. And then... You got any instants in that hand of yours?
Yeah.
Okay.
I am going
like
to...
Croatian Reclamation?
Well, it's just going to screw both of us.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Oh. I mean... No, just you. John did what he could this game.
It's true. I did what I could. I even tried to point out the Urborg play.
Yeah, he didn't just leave it out there.
Steven could have done it. He had multiple strip mines.
You're not wrong. Both
yeah,
of you
yeah,
had
I could have strip mined my own land. That didn't sound like a good play.
You I just told me that it was a good play if I did it.
I put the onus on you to do it, and you chose not to.
And that's why you're going to die.
yeah, I'm going to pay for his mistake. Exactly.
Not his mistake.
You had just as much of an opportunity.
I only
have one strip mine. I got that one shot.
That's right.
One shot in the whole game.
It's not necessarily true. I don't know your whole deck list.
I'm telling you, I got one you. Shot. All right, Jeremy, what's all going right. on over here?
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to equip.
Yep.
I'm going to tap it.
Yep.
To mill you four. I'm going to keep going through all these creatures unless anybody has responses.
They don't.
Oh, you can keep giving them haste.
Yeah.
All right. So it's 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19.
One,
and
two,
everything's tapped.
3, 4, 5, 6, oh, it's just
19
exact.
Total. Mm, got it. So 4, 8, is it 30, is it 26, 10, 13, 16, 17,
18, 19. Did it to all of them?
Just, all of these.
Yeah. All those are tapped.
Everything in play is tapped.
All right.
On this side of the board.
All right.
The only thing not tapped is Tasigur
and Phoenix
at the moment.
Okay. And this is presumably equipped it here.
Yes. Correct. And I will...
You will.
I will.
Yeah. It would have been.
I'm going to pass after that. All
right.
Stevie?
My turn? End of turn?
Yep.
I'm a vampire tutor.
Okay. All
right. 9.
Get a 9.
Delphine.
All right. My turn?
Yeah.
Upkeep. I'm going to die. But first.
Sacrifice
compulsion.
Okay. You could activate the top part of it first.
Then do it.
With all the triggers on the stack.
You were done, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Here we go. Big draw.
Big money, no whammies. Feel like that
I wish you wouldn't have killed my like, incubator.
I feel like that was a whammy.
It was not a whammy.
Oh, man.
I'm going to play Apex Warhawk.
There it is.
Amplify 2.
Oh, man.
Okay, you got a dice if you need one.
is a 4-4 flyer.
Yeah, it's a 4-4 flyer. Watch out. Watch out, everybody. This is going to be tough, John.
Yeah, tell me about it.
I can go into detail if you'd like.
Please don't.
He's got a lot of cards in his hand. We don't really have much.
Well, you have an opportunity to attack him.
Yeah. I am pretty low.
There is that.
He's at a mere 18.
Yeah.
It is a 1, 2, 3, 4 powered. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 powered creature.
Yeah. Currently. Yeah, don't you forget that mouth run on. Wait, where's the 5?
He's a 5.
One, he's snow.
2, 3,
oh, because he's snow, he's yeah. He's snow, you know.
He's snowy. All right. That's all I got.
Okay. During my upkeep, I'm going to sacrifice a harpy.
Oh, he lost all those creatures, right? All those creatures are gone.
All
those creatures
are gone, yeah. Are you stopping me? What's going on?
No, you're good.
He does all have right. A dissipate, so don't forget about it.
I will not forget. I'll draw.
He has every card that we've seen this entire game.
Pretty much.
Including a villainous wealth.
And a couple others you probably haven't seen this game.
Not many.
Just probably like right where I like. Right where I like it. Alright. Obnixilus reignited.
Oh. Gee.
Foil Ob.
Pre-release promo.
Baller.
That's right.
May or may not have walked into the battle from Syndicar pre-release.
I did.
And walked away with that.
I did. I was, you know, back.
Is it the same as this? Yes.
I got both of those, opened them both at the pre-release.
Wow.
Yeah. There's always like one card that I want. It's like one random black card for this deck. And I
have a
pretty good track record. Resolves?
Yeah.
All right. Well, I'm going to absolutely lose one life and draw a card. Now... Let me think about this first. I am going to do that. I want to make sure that that's what I 100% want to do, and it is what I want to do. Okay. 25. Hoo-ah.
Hoo-ah, indeed. Anytime here, Justin.
Yeah, well,
anytime.
He's at 18.
Yeah, I'm attacking him for 7.
I like seven. That's a lot.
What I can do.
Oh boy. Looks like he has something.
Not gonna turn out how
one,
I wanted
two,
it to.
3 mana.
I'll give you 3 here though.
I'll attack you for 1.
I'll take
7. See, that could have been a putrefy. He could have left my incubator. Not gonna make that.
He could have just not cast it.
I could have.
It's true. Now what you gonna do? Do you wanna get that
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Tap for 9.
That's a lot.
And, I'm going to cast Sheldred, Whispering One.
I'm going to dissipate that one.
Yeah, but I thought that you might.
How much mana are you floating? 2?
I have 2. 2 black mana floating.
You have potentially 3 mana.
Potentially 3.
Or you could funnel it in the Nykthos and still up to you.
I could.
Do potentially.
Well, that way I wouldn't waste it.
Yeah, that way you're not wasting anything, because we don't want to be wasteful.
No, we do not like to be wasteful. So I have 2 mana.
Nope.
Oh.
I have 4.
4, which is exactly enough.
To 4.
Which is exactly enough
to cast nothing.
To cast nothing.
I knew where he was going with this.
Disappointing.
Someone's getting milled. It's probably you, Joe.
Yeah. Well, he has enough. He doesn't have enough to mill me right now. He's not anywhere. Nowhere near.
He has 20 lands.
Yeah, whatever.
So that's like 35 cards.
I got like 5 lands. I've got like 60 cards.
So he's 25 lands.
Like 60.
He has like 50 cards.
26 lands.
26. Now he can.
Well, he's out of decks that can cast Eternal Witness.
Sure,
there is that.
He's kinda. He has his own Eternal Witness in his hand.
It's true.
He does. He showed it to me, and
we know that's in his hand.
Yeah. But still,
that decks mission
that can cast it.
20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26.
That's a lot. All right, so maybe you can.
Yeah.
Count it up.
7, 20.
You need one more. Oops.
Use the wrong land.
That's 26.
Trying to get a 1-minute discount.
26.
31.
Everybody's got one in their group like him.
4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9,
26 40. Plus 24. It's exactly 50.
52.
There we go. There's two more. 52. So for 49.
For 49.
This is how it ends.
Probably going to end with
ho!
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19.
Oh.
49 million.
That. Yeah, he's.
I gotta cast all of your stuff first.
Yeah. He's probably gonna be devoted. Yeah.
Wait. You have to cast all those cards, right?
Yes.
That's not a creature.
It's not a creature yet. But
so
as soon
close.
As he turns it into a creature, you'll be able to respond.
Yeah, that won't do much, but yeah. All right.
I don't even know what I want here.
This is all lands.
You have a
plethora. I have an embarrassment of purchase here.
At least
I'd say
one
you
of
probably
those.
Put them all into play and then mill John and then.
Well, they're all not active.
Yeah.
Only the old Phoenixes.
No, that's what it. You probably put them all into play and mill John
Phoenix
and then.
Isn't even active.
Oh, he will be.
Yeah, he'll find a way.
Yeah,
life will find a way.
Yeah, he needs a mere 4 blue mana symbols and. Plethora of cards.
Here's what I'm going to do.
What are you
going to
do?
I am going to not cast any of these. And I'm going to mill you for 3. And then I'm going to pass the turn and let Justin murder my face.
He cannot. You know, can only do 4 damage so far.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm not going to
untap. What damage can I do here before I go out?
What does putting an ice counter on target permanent?
It makes them bigger.
Oh.
Before I go out.
I'd turn them into ice permanents anyway, just in case.
Oh, they'll lose their counters.
There's just not.
How big is it?
This right now is a 2-3.
Oh. It's a 2-3?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But if you kill it, it gets to be bigger.
Yeah.
Yeah, it just doesn't work out, man. I just want to do some stuff for it. You know what? I want to do some stuff for it, bro. I don't care.
Just kill his turtle.
Yeah.
Kill Justin's turtle. No.
Kill that. All
right. So hateful.
Kill Justin's turtle.
I am killing Justin's turtle.
Well, that doesn't work. It still looks like a turtle.
It's a crypt swap. Yeah, get it out of here.
And then... gonna sack this Warhawk to draw card.
All right, you're dead.
I like it. Out on your own terms. Oh, no.
Hmm.
All right. Draw.
Remember what happened last season at the beginning of the season?
What's that?
You didn't kill Justin?
No. Yeah.
Then he killed you every game?
Yeah, you guys think that's going to happen, but it's just...
I'm personally hoping that Jeremy continues to have a lot of wealth. To be the 1% so that I can hate him more.
You see, you guys keep... You notice I keep looking at my graveyard because I'm really hoping that something is going to...
Something's going to change.
Something new is going to be in there.
I'm going to turn this radio to something skeleton. Oh, well.
I think you want that extra mana. I don't know for what. You should look. You should pay one life and draw another card.
Well, I know, but there's... Since I know this is my last turn...
You don't want to draw?
Well, I want to be sure that there's not anything in here that's going to actually help me, because I don't think that there is. So...
Just to be clear, he has a Wrath of God in his hand. Just so you remember.
He literally has 40 cards in his hand.
I
have to assume he has everything.
He has
this is my one shot.
Decree of Pain and a in
24. Okay, great. That was another land.
Well, if you draw him this turn, you can't draw him next turn. You're going to get one more turn. He can't mill you out this turn.
You're right.
We've established that he could have another land in his hand, so he could go up to a higher mill, but he has to get it back. You have Bajuka Bog? You can just end this right now.
I don't.
I don't, though.
Steven?
I don't. I wish I did, but I don't. Two, Jeremy.
Two.
15?
Oh, pass the turn.
Old Jeremy. He got another land in his hand. Oh, yeah, he did.
Attack land. I'm going to look at the top three and put it back
in. What difference does that make?
I was hoping he was out of them. He only put 26 lands total in his deck.
We knew that one was in his hand.
Unless there's
he's
a
got so many things.
So I can go up to 51 mana total.
You're going to add 27 this time instead of 26, and you will have 25 mana. So you get to 50.
I'm going
to
start counting these up.
You'll
by,
get
by
each. 10. Oh, you can't tap that one. You're
yeah,
right.
You can't 51. Tap that one.
Yeah.
That's
51
with that. Yeah. So, however, I can only.
This turn, you may only Villainous Wealth. You have to do it for three less because
yeah,
of the.
Because I have to go with the.
Eternal Witness.
Eternal Witness.
Yes. However, I'm sure that if you Villainous Wealth him and you happen to get a lot in his graves, you will be able to mill him out.
I don't play that stuff.
You do play Lightning Grease.
I don't have Lightning Grease.
Oh.
How many do you have here?
My general doesn't need it.
How many do you have here?
Yes, 60 right cards at least.
Like 60.
Like 60?
Yeah.
Okay. So we'll go Eternal Witness to get back Villainous Wealth.
So how much mana did you have?
He had 51. He has 48.
So I have 48.
He has to tap the Soul Ring, but he has 48.
Yeah. So you have 48 mana.
Yeah.
Okay.
Lots of it's black.
Some of it's not.
Some of it's not. That's fine. Yeah, we'll just go.
You had 53 mana.
How many?
Really?
Yeah. You had 27 lands. You tap two, you get 27 mana. Take three out of that, 24 gives you 51 mana plus two, 53 mana.
Yep. You're right.
So, 50, you're only for 47. 47.
Yeah. 47.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 7?
7.
Haha!
Yeah, I was trying to take lands out of him for him so he didn't have to look through that stuff.
There's a great merchant of Aspidall on that one. I don't think it's going to go.
Hush came over the crowd.
Yeah. Hush.
Is there a dream merchant in there?
Oh, yeah. You're going to kill him.
I'm going to kill him.
You're probably going to dream me for about 50.
Yeah, there's
Necrotal.
Yeah, there's a lot.
There's a
targeting
lot.
Eternal count Witness.
There's
count it. Count it.
Count it. 2, 4, 5, 6. Six right there.
You're not getting all my creatures.
Enchantments. Oh, look, I also
yeah, just
have
put all the black cards here.
Yeah, I'm trying to look for all of them.
Well, this is another
that,
one.
Matt, he's gonna get up to nope. Nope, not getting all of them.
Okay. He's going to target Puppeteer. Or Masker Worm.
Yeah. Nope. Masker Worm on
two,
top.
4, 8.
We'll watch where you
4, at. 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. Yeah, you real dead.
You're dead.
Buddy. Great merchant.
Did you count these?
Why does he get those?
31.
Did he not cast Rise of the Dark Realms, which is most certainly in my deck?
No, I'll be dead.
I don't know if
I'm
he got
sure it. It's on there somewhere.
Ah, right
yeah,
here.
He did.
Yeah, he did. He yeah. killed you.
Now, how much is it? Okay, I'm dead.
Well, you did what you wanted to do.
Yeah,
he's
wealthy.
Yeah. Turns out.
Sweet card.
Yeah. It may be more along the lines of me and Justin want to punish each other, and you know that happening.
Steven, you are just a spiteful person, and you made me spiteful because
I didn't
you.
Make you spiteful.
You did.
You chose like out of spite not to spite in order to spite.
What? I don't know. What
he chose out of spite in order to spite me. He didn't spite him.
So how you been?
I've been good. It was a good match. I had foam my deck.
I think it was a lot of fun.
I got to cast a lot of birds.
Yeah.
You cast more of my deck than your deck.
I really did. I cast pretty much all of every one of your decks
for, sure.
for the most part.
Yeah, like I said.
No, you didn't.
Only half a hiss.
You didn't cast any of mine.
That's true.
I did. Wow, he was like,
hand those back.
This is crap. I don't want any of this.
That's
don't
great.
Spend the time on that.
You could have done that with me, too. I just not cast any of them.
But Gary's such a fun card.
Yeah, usually. Yeah.
Who's Gary?
Gray Merchant.
I knew that, but maybe they didn't.
Yeah. Okay. For the folks at home.
Yeah. I felt I didn't get to do what I wanted to do, really.
Yeah.
I kind of was...
You mean you didn't get to make us sacrifice things?
I didn't really get to do anything.
Yeah, there was some sacrificing, but it wasn't a lot on our
You did a little bit. You blacked some Xena.
Your Surfs came into play multiple times.
Yeah, you reanimated that Surf thing multiple times.
Well, actually, most other people reanimated.
That's true.
Yes.
Yeah. You got it once, I got it once.
I had a nice aggressive
surf,
start.
Surf's up. Yeah. Surf was up. Birds were ready. Man. Well, I mean, you said the point of the deck, make a lot of mana, cast Villainous Wealth.
Cast Villainous Wealth.
Every turn, you made a lot of mana, and you cast Villainous Wealth.
That's what I did.
I can't really fault you for doing what you told us you were going to do at the beginning, so, you know.
We felt the pain. Kinda,
yeah. I don't like getting all drained out by my...
Yeah, no, it's that greed picture with him puking up gold. That's what we did. We just...
This really is a great card.
It's fantastic.
Yeah.
The art's really cool, too.
As soon as I saw that scroll, pretty much all throughout my Magic history, I've wanted, like, the big, dumb X spells, like Genesis Wave and stuff like that. I've just wanted to cast, and this one combined the idea of I want to cast other people's spells and big, dumb X spells.
It's like the perfect intersection of what you want to do.
It really is.
You don't talk about all gold everything, John.
Yeah. Villainous Wealth is probably... One of the
That's
more
a lot of gold.
Everything
a lot of gold.
Cards.
Yeah, it's a lot of gold, and you cast everything. So,
No, not everything.
It's not
none
the
John's
birds.
None of the birds.
Did not cast any of those spells.
Steven, are you upset that the T-Rex arm got chopped off every time?
No, that's what's supposed to happen.
What?
They're supposed to chop. I mean, I play him and he gets his arm chopped off. That would be the problem of playing the Mimeoplasm with your group. You play it and they're just like. Oh, that's really good.
I get the same effect with Kangee.
I don't think you did.
No, I don't.
I do on sight. I felt the wrath.
Every single time?
Yeah.
I do with Maelstrom Wander a lot more than this one.
I'm like,
that's just got a big target right now.
I'm like, oh, for life against Kangee.
It's true.
Just saying. And Kangee didn't win, but I didn't win either.
He didn't win.
At least he gave you second.
God, yeah.
Gave it to you.
I feel like it was like a, oh, I feel threatened by you the least.
No, he
That's
he
definitely
was,
what it was.
Yeah,
he was the king, and he had all the wealth, and he was giving out titles.
Yeah.
He gave me fourth, he gave him third.
Just think that for a second.
Collecting the taxes.
He felt more
threatened by the birds of war.
By the bird.
Yeah.
It was more so I knew I could probably mill you entirely in one turn, and I could not him.
Mm-hmm. No.
You didn't want to need it to. You just would have killed him and then had more left than John could do in damage.
That's true. Yeah.
That would have happened too.
I could do lots of damage.
So, thank you guys for watching. We hope you enjoyed our personal decks. This is what you guys wanted. This is all stuff that we like to do. Jeremy got to cast Villainous Wealth like a billion times. Steven got to do Graveyard Shenanigans. John got to put Bird Warriors into play.
Bird Soldiers.
Yeah, and so it's, you know, everyone kind of got to do what they wanted to do. So this is what we like. Now, next week, and going forward for the rest of the season, we're going to be trying to do what you guys like based on suggestions you guys have made in the past. I feel like we have a really good lineup for this season. Some things that you've asked for sure. This is one of them. But you definitely want to subscribe to make sure you're getting all the Commander versus action, especially if you notice we put stuff out in between seasons. So we're in the season now, but eventually this season is going to end too, and we're going to have some more content out after that. So you want to be subscribed to make sure you catch all that. Like this video 7,000 or more times, please, because we're not making much ground on the chest stash.
Maybe the people are protecting themselves from themselves.
Maybe.
They just go through and delete the lights.
They were like, wait, we're getting close to 7. We really don't want to see this. So let's just scale it back a little bit.
Maybe it needs to be like an anti chest dash.
Maybe I need to show up with a chest dash every day until we get 7,000.
Oh, jeez.
I do not want that.
Then,
then other people in the studio would stop showing up.
Yeah.
So I don't know if that would work. So after you like and subscribe,
make sure you comment about which one of our decks you enjoyed, and let us know, like, what do you like to do in Commander? Like, obviously, you kind of saw the stuff that we like to do, but what of these do you feel like you, you know, have, like, a connection with, if any, or what you personally like to do? What's your favorite deck? So we can have a discussion about that, and make sure you're sharing this with everyone on social media, whatever social media you like to go by, YouTube, Facebook, Twitter.
Instagram.
Steven, you probably still have a MySpace.
It's true. He checks it regularly.
Don't you?
His Look GeoCities page.
GeoCities, yeah, that's a good one.
Oh,
yeah. So be sure, like, subscribe, comment, share. So with that, Jeremy, you
clearly
ended up in the last, in kind of the the seat at the end last season. But
I was getting there a little bit near the end. But yeah, I couldn't quite.
I see you were just you're saving yourself for the beginning of this season.
Yeah, that's it.
Could this be the season of Jeremy?
He's sitting in the seat.
Sitting in the winner's seat. True. Gotta just, the crown comes right down from here.
It's true. That, well, Steven, that also means that you're sitting in the loser seat.
No.
And if there's one thing.
Well, okay, so I know we're, basically I've already won this season.
How so?
Because I'm sitting on green.
Okay.
Yeah, like I've already won the season.
Preemptively won the season because he's got the green flame.
Well, Steven, that's if I have anything to do with that, that's all you'll have.
And that is fine. Because like I said, I've already won the season.
I will willingly take third. If you get last, John gets second, and Jeremy wins. I'll sacrifice myself to do that. Now I'd love to get third, but if it starts breaking in a different way, then I'm just saying. Okay. I'm just saying.
I see how it is.
You've got the key maker over here, apparently.
All right, Jeremy. Haven't said this in a little while, but final thoughts from the winner.
I basically summed it up. Like I said, love X spells. Love playing with other people's cards. I guess the new thing that people have been doing because of Steven is hashtag Team Jeremy with a G. So
yeah, that sounds right for Steven.
All the fans.
Hashtag Team Jeremy sucks.
Hashtag Team Jeremy. Or hashtag Holy Guacanole.
Holy Guacanole. Yeah, I'm a big fan of that one.
I really like that one.
Oh, yeah, man.
So all the fans out there, make sure you hashtag who you're rooting for.
Yeah, yeah.
Make sure the hashtag Team Green fans boo the hashtag Team Jeremy.
You gotta represent. Look, Team Parnell, I know you guys are out there. We need first place finishes, not second place finishes. That's for John Suarez. Okay? We can leave that for John. That's all I'm saying.
Mm-hmm.
And with that, for season 4 runner-up John Suarez, for the current but soon to be not champion for this season,
Dynasty,
Stephen Green.
Yes.
For today's winner, Jeremy Noell, I'm Justin Parnell, and we'll see you guys next week.